that's completely untrue. I have a few people here, my boy Garrett, my boy Benny, and my wife Autumn, and all the visions and visionary he's talking about has been my wife and my dream. From when we kayaked in Alaska together, when we job shared kindergarten and first grade together. So what is culminating here at Toyon, which I'll talk about Toyon in a second, is really what we've done. Now we're at different schools, but that hasn't changed our partnership and what we want to accomplish in education and in our community. So you can give a big round of applause for Autumn. Thank you. With that said, I think I'm very fortunate to be a part of the district, and I feel like this accolade right here is a representation of a district that really feels that teaching the whole child is really important and has chosen somebody that is on kind of doing those things with art and with gardening, with vocational education and all those different things that I personally feel like not more important than anything else, but certainly as important as so many things that we're standardizing and needing to teach kids. But I really feel that these things are all really important, and kudos to you guys for keeping art programs and keeping music programs when other districts aren't able to, and really keeping that at the forefront and important in our district. So thank you guys very much for that. And Jeff here has been a phenomenal principal. Talk about a visionary and somebody with great aspirations for kids and community and all that. Really phenomenal to walk into his school and really be given the clean slate. We've done a lot of this League of Democratic Schools together. We've done a lot of different things that really focus on building community with kids, building, you know, taking kids to that next level. And he's been an incredible inspiration and visionary in that. So big round of applause for Jeff. He's retiring this year, so and last but certainly not least, Toyon Middle School, where I landed. This is what's being happening there is definitely not an independent venture at all. It's not about an individual, it's about a group of people. Amazing staff there, all of which are doing amazing things. Karen Wallison and Doug Clark are also teaming with me on a lot of things that we're speaking of. And I'm not going to go in and mention everybody who's doing amazing things there, but it really is a staff of lots of visionaries and lots of people doing really good stuff for kids. So I've been very fortunate to land in that. But thank you to the Rotary for this honor. It really is an honor when you think about all the amazing teachers in our school district and all the great things that everyone's doing for kids. That really, it is an honor when you think about the perspective of that. So thank you very, very much.
Mark Welty, Morgan, I always say his name wrong too, so, but I got it right today. Another art teacher. I was thinking what to say about Mark. I think a good teacher inspires kids to have confidence in that teacher. I think a great teacher like Mark, he inspires kids to have confidence in themselves. And if you go in his classroom, it's amazing. I mean, I have kids, I don't know if Mark knows it, they need, some of them need that classroom to be able to see issues that you see. They can't. I mean, they're science kids, math kids, I can't do it. I can't draw, I use stick figures, I can't do that. And then they get in Mark's class and they create wonderful things. They all become artists. When I go into his classroom, all students are engaged. It seems effortless on his part. I know it's not. I never have a problem in that class. Kids enjoy the class. They're proud of their work. He just does a tremendous job. And I've said many times, I wish I could clone him. And not only because I don't have enough sections of art, and I could put him in other departments too, but he does a fantastic job for us. And he coaches for us, and he's going to be playing guitar on the chocolate field, on the guitar with a teacher band, so that would be fun to watch. And he's just a joy to have our guys.
Well,
focus on my own aspirations as much as I really truly want my students to be successful. I want to focus more on that. And so when this honor came up, I opened the letter from Mr. Clemente, and I thought, oh, this isn't a typical letter that anybody has to write. There's something wrong with it. And it took me back. It took me a little while to actually absorb the scope of really this honor. And so I just wanted to thank the administration for valuing the art program, valuing what we're doing in that that aspect of what is Bret Hart. And so thank you very much.
Programs for at-risk students and students with special needs, and I'm going to ask Robin Searway and Patty Haskell, who are our special education program managers and director, to come up along with our teacher of the year, Arnett Craddy.
Have to learn how to play the ukulele. So I went by the classroom one day, and there they all were, all the different colored ukuleles up on the wall. And so Arnett has never taken one music lesson, but she decided, you know, if she was going to have her students on, she was going to have to practice herself. So the day we finished, she had her brand new ukulele in its case, and she was going home to practice for the next lesson. So anyway, I just sat at a recent IEP with Arnett, and again, I was so impressed with your knowledge base in special ed and the level of expertise that you bring to your job. Arnett, you have certainly made a difference in children's lives and the students. Like I said, I was in that IEP, it's where I'm going to get a little teared up, I think. And we kind of had a difficult situation. But she called me like a couple days before and said, hey, I just want to let you know what this family is going through to kind of give you a heads up so you know where we're going with this IEP. And through it all, she just was so wonderful to these parents to bring them along and provide support. And so with that, I'm truly thankful that you are a mentor to all our staff and an inspiration to your students. And so I already mentioned that Arnett is married, and she's here with Ron back there, her husband. And they do have two sons and three daughters that are successful, educated adults, as well as four grandchildren between the ages of 6 and 9. So congratulations.
Ages of 9 months.
Oh, 6 and 9 months, that's right.
Oh, no.
That's true. So yeah. Congratulations.
District's Teacher of the Year. Do you know what I mean?
Author William Ward wrote, "The mediocre teacher tells the good teacher, explain. The superior teacher demonstrates, the great teacher inspires." During her 17-year tenure with Mark Twain School District, Ms. Zimmerman has inspired hundreds of children. Professor Howard Hendricks states, "Teaching that impacts is not head-to-head, but heart-to-heart. Darcy has touched the hearts of so many fortunate children." Her colleagues state, "She is a dedicated teacher who takes her career very personally. It is part of who she is. She has been a great resource for ideas and new ways of doing things over the years, as well as a problem solver. She will always advocate for the students." Others state that she is professional, genuine, really and truly dedicated. She's done an amazing job with having the 4-5 split for years, and she has always had a large number of students in her class that always manages to give 100%. I am honored to be associated with Ms. D, Ms. Zimmerman. She greets every student in her combination 4-5 class with a handshake in the morning outside her door and bids them farewell with another handshake at the end of the day. Her students come to school because of what she does. She teaches, they learn, all 37 of them. It is my pleasure to introduce you to our teacher and inspiration of the year, Ms. Darcy Zimmerman. And I just want to say that when I was a student teacher, my master teacher said, "You'll find that there are teachers who are naturals as teachers, and there are those who aspire to be a natural but never really quite have the talent." And I would tell you that in my years of working in education, I always looked for those natural teachers. And there are a lot of teachers who aspire, but there's very few that really truly hit that mark of being a natural teacher, meaning they have that almost sixth sense about what works for kids and how to work with kids and just the basics. And Darcy's definitely a natural. I hear from her colleagues that, you know, if they want to know how to get results with kids, they go to Darcy. And she really does have a really sixth sense about how to get results with kids and every one of the kids in her class, no matter how large it is. And we really appreciate Darcy. She's a great teacher, and she is really worthy of this honor. So I'm glad to say thank you, Darcy, for being a teacher in our district.
Nervous talking in front of grown-ups because they're so quiet. I'm probably going to repeat what other people have said. You know, I could teach a bunch of kids, me, and first kids. You know, when I first came to Mark Twain, it was kind of a rough school. And, you know, I just watched it blossom over the last 15 or so years, and because of our administrative support, and I really was proud of the people who teach part of that school. You know, all our first-grade teachers, we all teach something different. None of us do the same job. You know, there's one fifth-grade teacher, and one fourth-grade teacher, and a bunch of splits in between. We all kind of have to have our own little spot in the world, but we all work pretty hard to work together. So it's all because of that, too. So thanks, Kathy, for being here. Oh, you bet.
She took all 37 kids to Sacramento yesterday.
Yeah.
And they were down at Sutter's Fort and other places doing California history. And Kathy, we feel bad Carl couldn't be here, so would you get take a plate or we'll get
okay.
Okay, and our last district is the one closest to our home here, Vallecito School District. So Phil Parisi, who's the principal of Michelson, will come up along with their Teacher of the Year, Kathy Grover. Come on, Kathy.
Another kind of art that Kathy has perfected, and
it's the integration of art, science, social studies, music, hands-on, project-based type education. And that is what Kathy really exemplifies as a teacher. Yesterday, I had the privilege of being in her classroom, and there were California lady caterpillars on one side. We were doing a lesson about germination, and that was going to then be followed through in our master garden. She works with our master gardeners on Thursday, as well as our community garden. And so we were reading a story, we were working on some things together, and all the kids just turned around because over here, they were hatching praying mantises, and I think they're up to about 150 right now. And so in the middle of a very stormy day when the praying mantises are supposed to be going outside, due to our weather right now, they're staying inside. So she has caterpillars, praying mantises, and bird girders. And that's talent to be able to do that. So, Kathy, I appreciate everything you do. I know your colleagues do. She's taking on a huge project at Michelson, working with students in painting tiles that we will be, they've been fired in a kiln. Kathy has taken on that entire responsibility in organizing it, and it will be grouted in all of our planters in the school as a form of beautification. And that really is your dedication, and your colleagues have admired that as well. It has taken a tremendous amount of work and effort. But thank you so much for being here and for being a great teacher.
Thank you, Phyllis. Teachers do so much, and it just always amazes me when I go home in the later hours, sometimes of the evening, and think, wow, I just didn't get like that. I go home, I can't do it now, I'm tired. And we'll go back, and everybody here that's a teacher knows that. I want to digress just a tiny, teeny bit. I spoke in front of a Rotary Club in the mid-70s, when Jeannie, Lola, and I started the Murphy Preschool. And I was afraid to get up in front of the group. And I had been a teacher for 3 years, and then I was a mom, and I had three kids. And we were organizing the preschool, and we needed things. And somebody said, oh, the Rotary Club will support you. And I thought, well, that's great. Can I just write them a letter? Oh, no. They want you to pre-mint. And so we had taken slides with our slide cameras and put them on the projector and projected them on the screen. And I think it was, we got the little church in Murphy's where we did this. Anyway, I got up and spoke to the Rotary Club. And I don't know if there's any Rotarians that were here in the mid-70s or not, but they supported our preschool and got picnic tables and some play equipment that we desperately needed because we were just a little co-op. And anyway, I thanked Rotary Club then, and I thank you today for this wonderful award, which I accept with honor, with encouragement from my staff, and like the other gentleman said, it's a real humbling thing because anybody on board the staff could deserve this award. I work with the most wonderful people, and everybody's dedicated, and it's just a real pleasure to represent them today.
And we have to recognize Doug Grover, who's in the back there. Doug, too, cooks dinner every night. I'll get a dinner tonight. Just as we wrap this up, I'm going to ask Ed to come up just a second while I share it. Well, I'll share a quick story, because one thing you have to do as a teacher is be flexible and quick on your feet. And Jeff, I remember fondly Catherine Marsh, who taught at San Andreas for many years, and I visited Catherine's class one morning, and she was doing the morning exercises with the kids. She taught first grade. And so she had up on the board, what the morning exercises were. So she said, okay, what's the weather out today? And the kids said, oh, it's sunny out. She had a sun on the board, and she said, and what's today's date? And they said, it's February 13th or something like that. And she goes, that's right, and let's write February down. Who would like to go up and write down February? The little boy raised his hand. So he went up to the board, and he started writing an F, a small lowercase F. And she said, oh, remember the rule. And he thought for a minute, and he erased it, and he put a capital F. And she said, why does that have to be a capital F? And he said, because it's the F word. County superintendent's in the back of the room. Okay, well, you can see why I've enjoyed working in Calaveras County for 30 years. All of the teachers inspire us. And I asked Ed to come up because during lunch he shared something at the table. I'm going to ask you to repeat about being here with the students and the teachers and the little visits you went on with.
I came straight here with my wife's a real estate agent. She works with a lot of distressed properties and foreclosures and short sales and the like. And it's not a good thing sometimes. And today was a rough time for her. And because she had to evict somebody and go over with the sheriff's department and lock this house up. And as I walked through that house, as I've done a couple times before with her, I felt the pain of the children. You could see their report cards laying in the trash and some of their toys and their pictures. And I really needed to come here today and sit next to people like Morgan and see these outstanding youth and these kids and the teachers that are here to kind of lift me back up, because it's nice to see the parents and people care.
Thank you all for being here.
And of course, a big round of applause for our friend, Mr. Brown. John is also the MC of the Miss Calaveras pageant. Now, somebody asked me earlier how many years you've been the MC of the pageant.
8 or 9, I think. Dave gave it up about 2001 or something. So.
Okay. I'll put that on your permanent record then.
Thank you.
Now we come to our club members' favorite part of the meeting. It's the raffle. Does everybody have a little red ticket?
Yes.
If you don't have a red ticket, now's your chance. Well, I've got 3 or 4 left up here. So, if you're a member of the club, then we pull your red tickets, then you get to try to pull out the marble. If you pull out the marble, you get $750. If you are not a member of the club and pull your tickets, you get $25 right here and now. Seems like an equitable trade, right? John, am I missing anything? Do we have any other announcements?
No, just a reminder for the students and teachers to meet you out back for a picture afterwards.
And of course, for the members next week, Alton Park and Murphy Youth Honors Barbecue for the students who all made honor roll. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Well, let's see. Who will we let pull the ticket today? How about you, young man? Come here. But first, do you have your own ticket with you? No, leave it on the table. No.
My kid,
I know. Let me get mine. Hold on. All right, what are the last three numbers?
7, 4, 5.
Does anybody have 7, 4, 5? Winner! And he's the winner!